Dach has it on the right boards at the hash mark. He's going to try and make a move. He'll shoot, score! What a shot by Kirby Dach!
Hello everyone, I'm Andy Liu from Future Consideration, and today we'll take a closer look at Canadian top prospect Kirby Dach. The 6'4 center is seen by many as the third best player of the draft after Jack Hughes and Kaapo Kakko. After a strong Linka Gretzky performance, accumulating 7 points in 5 games, he is now dominating the WHL with 32 points in 19 games, taking the third spot in the WHL scoring leaderboard. Just for comparison, in the U18 season, Nolan Patrick had 1.42 points per game, Cody Glass had 1.36 points per game, and Mathieu Borzal had 1.30 points per game. So stat-wise, Kirby Dach looks really good, but how does he stand out on the ice? Without waiting any longer, let's look at every aspect of his game. That means his skating, shooting, passing, stick handling, defensive play, physicality, hockey IQ, and competitiveness. Let's start with one of the most important categories in today's NHL, skating. Dach has a surprisingly quick stride, which allows him to accelerate pretty quickly and have a great agility, especially for a 6'4 center. He does not have an amazing top speed, but he isn't lacking in that aspect too. He can start rushes, pass defensemen, generate zone entries, or put quick pressure on the forecheck with his good speed. Overall, Dach's skating isn't on Hughes, Keiko, or Cozens level, but it's just good enough to allow him to dominate with other aspects of his game. I would give him 4 stars. Let's pass to his shooting. Dach has a great finishing around the net. He has both a very powerful wrist shot and slap shot. The problem with Dach is that he's just too generous. Just last Linka Gretzky, he went on a breakaway and sent the puck to his teammate behind when he clearly had the better angle. He will need to be more confident in his shot, but I'm not worried with that as he shared the same thoughts on various interviews and he's already starting to shoot more this season. He currently has 11 goals this season, which is already surpassing his 2017-18 projection. I think Dach has one of the most underrated shots of the draft. I would give him 4 stars for now, but it could easily become a 5 stars by the end of the season. Let's talk about his passing. Dach is one of, if not the best playmaker of the draft. He has an amazing vision and he can find teammates cross-ice with ease. He creates so many scoring chances with great passes in the slot or in the crease. He has a great saucer pass which he often uses to feed his linesmate in front of the net. He also loves to push the defense back and drop the puck to open the play. His puck distribution on the power play is also excellent. He currently has 21 passes in 19 WHL games. I would definitely give him 5 stars. Let's now pass to his stick handling. Dach has some surprisingly slick hands with which he often uses to make room for himself after a quick zone entry or when he is cornered by the defenseman. He can make a move to get a better shooting line, but he usually tries to dangle his opponent to have more time and space to make the right pass to his teammate. His fluent hands often helps him to get out of trouble, so I not only like his skills, but also the way he uses it. It makes him very effective and this style of game will be easier to translate to the pro level in my opinion. I will give him 4 stars. Let's now look at his defensive play. Dach's defensive game is the most underrated aspect of his game. In the defensive zone, he is active behind the net and in the crease, helping his defensemen, but it's in the neutral and offensive zone that Dach excels. With his great strength and stick lifts, he blocks a ton of zone breakouts and entries from the opponent. He gives a very tough time to attackers trying to start the offense, and if he doesn't stop his enemy, he will at least destabilize them to make the job easier for his defensemen. Not only does he help prevent offensive chances, but he also creates offense with those takeaways. On the face-off, Dach has a bit more difficulties. He won 42% of his face-offs so far this season, and it's an aspect to improve. I will give him 4 stars. Let's pass to physicality. Being 6'4 and 198 pounds, Dach starts with a step ahead. He has an amazing puck protection and he can literally shield the puck from any player. He is able to circle it around the ice with his puck so easily. He has a great strength which helps him in board battles and on the forecheck. He never goes out of his way to hit someone, but he uses his great upper body strength in every aspect of the play. I will give him 5 stars. Let's now talk about his hockey IQ. Dach has a somewhat quick decision making and he always makes the right play. And always makes the smart play. He knows when to strike to destabilize his opponent with stick lift or quick pressure. He is able to get into the back of the defense with his great offensive instinct. He also loves to create space for his teammate by pushing back the defense. I would give Dach 4 stars. Let's look at his competitiveness. Dach puts effort in both ends of the ice. He is intense on the forecheck and on the backcheck. He almost always keeps his feet moving. I will give him 4 stars. As you can see with the result, I think Dach is a very complete forward. Apart from his lack of confidence in his shot and face-off, he has no real weakness. Personally, I think Dach represents the perfect center as he can be dominant on both ends of the ice and create scoring chances for the whole team. If something Cozens, Barham, Podkozym, Broberg or even Turcotte are better than Dach, he is by quite a margin the third best prospect on my board and my favorite junior player. But anyway, what's your opinion on Kirby Dach? Is he a top 3 prospect or do you have him lower on your list? I would love to hear your thoughts in the comments below. Subscribe for more NHL draft related videos and click here to see my previous scouting reports on 2018 eligibles. I'll see you for the next one. Here not, here I come, you can't hide. Ready or not, here I come.